So hello students, in this video we will be study about National Human Rights Commission, means NHRC. So let's study what is NHRC, what is about. See, National Human Rights Commission of India is an independent statutory body, means here independent statutory body means it is a non-constitutional body which is set up by a parliament, okay, which is set up by a parliament. Statutory bodies are authorized, means to pass the law and to take decisions on the behalf of a state or a country. That is called as NHRC is an independent statutory body, okay. In India, it was established on 12th October 1993, okay. In India, it was established on 12th October 1993 as the Protection of Human Rights Act in 1993, and later it was amended in 2006, okay, established in 12th October 1993 because of as a provision of Protection of Human Rights Act, and later it has become amendment in 2006, okay. Next is National Human Rights Commission has celebrated its silver jubilee, means it has completed 25 years on 12th October 2018. Okay, it has completed its silver jubilee, means it has completed its 25 years on October 12, 2018. And one more important, this NHRC is located, or its headquarter is in New Delhi, okay. Its headquarter is in New Delhi. And one more, it is like a watchdog of human rights in the country, means it acts like a watchdog of the human rights of the country, like the rights related to life, means it relates the rights related to life, like liberty, means liberalizations, or equality and dignity of individual guaranteed by the Indian constitutions, okay. Next, it was established in conformity with the this principle, okay. It was established by the conformity of with the Paris principle, adopted for the promotion and protection of human rights in Paris in October 1991, and endorsed by General Assembly of the United Nations 20 December 1993, okay. Next is what are human rights, okay. See, what are human rights means, as per United Nations definition, these rights are inherent to all human beings regardless of their race, gender, nationality, language, religion, or any other status, means. Next, human rights includes, for the human rights includes, it includes right to life of an individual's liberty, freedom from slavery. Slavery means a condition of having work very hard without proper remuneration, means a person who used to work very hard where he does not get his proper wages or salary on time. We should make freedom from slavery and torture, giving in unnecessary torture in working conditions. And everyone should have freedom from opinion. Whatever the opinion they have, they can tell and they can express their opinions. And they have right to work, means right to work means equal work, where men and women should have right to work and proper educations for both men and women and many more, okay. This above all rights are entitled to everyone, means everyone are entitled this human rights, means individual have this human rights without any discrimination. We can tell bhedbhav, without any discrimination. These are called human rights. Means what are the background, means how the National Human Rights came into an existence, means how human rights came into existence. There is a Universal Declaration of Human Rights, means UDHR, was adopted by the United Nations of General Assembly in Paris on December 10, 1948. Okay, UDHR was adopted by the United National Assembly in which country? In Paris, on 10th December 1948. And one more, it is a milestone declaration in the history of human rights, which was sets out for the first time. It is also called as fundamental human rights to be universally protected. It means where these all fundamental rights should be protected all over universally. Okay, and one more, human right days is observed every year. Means it is observed everywhere on 10th December, which is the anniversary of this UDHR. In 2018, Human Rights Day is marked the 17th anniversary of the declaration. Okay. Next, in due to the growing importance of strengthening national human rights, institution has been recognized, and in 1991, a union meeting in Paris has been developed a detailed set of principles. Means, what happens growing importance? What happens? A union meeting was held in Paris to develop a certain principles. Means that is called Paris Principle. They have set a name that is called Paris Principle. This principle became foundation for the establishment and operation of national human rights institutions. In pursuant to this principle, India has enacted Protection of Human Rights Act 1993 with the view to bring a greater accountability and strengthening of rights in the country. With this Paris principle, India also enacted this to protect every human rights, that is called as Protection of Human Rights Act 1993, with a view to bring stronger accountability. Okay, this act also authorized state government to establish Human Rights Commission. Okay, this also state that every state, means every state, we have 28 states, in that all 28 states, there should be also a state human rights commissions. Means there should be one national human rights commissions, which is headquartered in New Delhi. Apart from that, we have 28 states. In that 28 states, all one state should be a state human rights commission should be there. Next is structure of the commission. The commission means who are all the persons involved in the NHRC. Means what are the persons are there? Okay, first see, NHRC is a multi member body which consists of a chairperson. Okay, in NHRC, first it consists of one chairman out and seven other members. Okay, first there will be a chairman and the other seven members. Out of seven members, there will be three ex officio members. Okay, first there will be head, that is called as chairman, and there will be seven other members. Out of these seven members, three will be ex officio members. Okay, president appoints the chairman and members. Means in national human rights commissions, for this chairman and other members, who will appoint? President will appoint. How will appoint? On the recommendation of high committee headed by the prime ministers. Okay, see, in national human rights commissions, for the chairman and other members is appointed by the president on the recommendation of the prime ministers. Okay, this chairperson or chairman and the other members of the NHRC is appointed for the 5 years. Means they hold this office for 5 years or till the age of 70 years, whichever is earlier. Okay, don't confuse. These members hold the office for 5 years or until the age of 70 years. And one more, they can be removed only on the charges of provided misbehavior or incapacities provided by an inquiry conducted by the Supreme Court judge. This chairman and other members can be removed. How they can remove means they have behaved any misbehavior or incapacity of other work they have done. Okay, commission also have specialized 5 divisions. Okay, See, commission also have 5 specialized divisions. 5 specialized division. One is law division, second is investigation divisions, policy and research, policy research and program divisions, training division and administrative division. See what happens in law divisions. The law division of the commissions handles a registrations. Okay, this commissions handles a registrations and a disposal of around 1 lakh cases. Okay, in law division he handles how many cases? 1 lakh cases every year, means each year registered on the complaints of human rights. This cases will be on the register of complaints of human rights violations made it either by victim or any of the persons on behalf of the victim of on the receipt of intimation from other authorities. This is called as law divisions. Next comes investigation divisions. In this investigations, it is headed by an officers, like we call as officers of the rank of Director General Police, assisted by 1 DIG and 3 senior superintendent of police. Each senior superintendent of police heads a group of investigate officers. Okay, the functions of investigation divisions is multidimensional details of which they handle, like they take off spot inquiries like custodial death, fact of finding case, etc. This is called as investigation division. Next is policy research and programs. In this, what happens? The policy research projects and we also call as programs undertakes and promotes of research of human rights and organize conference like seminars and workshops on on important human rights issues. Whenever the commission on the basis of hearings, deliberation or otherwise arise at a conclusions that a particular subject of its importance. Okay, next comes training divisions. What happens in training divisions? The training division is responsible for spreading human rights literacy among various sections of the society. As such, it trains and sensitizes various government officials and functions of state and agency of non-government officials or representative of civil society organizations. Okay, next come last is administration divisions. What happens in the administrative divisions? Looks after the establishment like administrative and related requirements of the chairpersons and members of NHRC. Besides, it looks into personal accounts, library and other requirements of the officers of the staff of the NHRC. Okay, and one more, the third point says as the chairperson and members of state commissions are appointed by the government. Okay, as I told, 28 states are there. In every states there will be a state human rights commissions. For this, state commissions are appointed by the governor with consultant with the chief ministers as well as home ministers of speaker of legislative assembly and the leader of opposition's party. Don't make confuse. In NHRC, the chairman and other persons are appointed by president with the recommendation of prime minister. When come into the state commissions, it is appointed by the governor with the consultant of chief ministers or home ministers or speaker of legislative assembly. Okay.